Good morning. Good morning. I'm just going to add the Facebook to a few groups as per usual. Bear with me, please. Say hello if you can see the live and shout out that you can hear me okay before we get going. Yes. So just waiting for people to find the group. So, hello guys. Just wait for a moment or two. Good morning, how are you on this Sunday morning? It's a little chilly. Please shout out if you can hear me okay, guys, and see the live. Yeah. Good morning, Tanya. Good morning, Julie. Okay. So we will get going in a second. How is everybody? It's been quite a deeply shifting and maneuvering week, I feel energetically. Yeah. Oh, hey, Raul. Yeah, I'm sure it is a little chilly down your way, too. So, really, I just wanted to hop on this morning and do a little bit of a channeling, a little bit of light language, a bit of a card reading, just for the what's going on over the past week, what people may be tuning into personally and energetically themselves, or maybe it's been triggered by the collective field at the moment, the collective overall themes that are coming through in the energy of this time as we move into the Leo season, deep feels, deep heart stuff, deep courage. Deep courage, I feel, also to go into, I guess, places that we've avoided or places that have been unearthed in the last little while to explore, to examine, to bring into union and to bring into self-acceptance. Yeah. Hello, Maria. Marie. Hello, Carolina. So basically, I just hopped on today because it feels like so much is happening energetically. It's very deep at the moment, very old energies coming up, a density coming up to release in the central core as we move through some very interesting times. I did pick three cards for tuning into the collective consciousness right now and to just to give us a little bit of well, a little hope and a little bit of grounding and a little bit of gathering of our souls, really, so that we can feel that we're part of the bigger whole and that we're not doing all this solo work on our own, blah blah blah. Okay, so a gathering of the tribe, if you will, yeah, for me as well, yeah. So the first card they picked for the collective consciousness, the rainbow, a sweet relief, new beginnings, and a new way forward. Yeah, sweet relief. So this card, these are the Healing Waters Oracle by Rebecca Campbell. I'm loving these cards lately. Yeah. So I feel like this is just a reminder that whatever you're going through right now, whatever you're feeling, whatever emotions are coming up from the past, that are arising for you to sort of witness, to accept, to validate yourself in, to have self-compassion around, and to resolve so that you can move and step forward into this new way. A deep transitional moment, I feel. Once again, an upgrade time. So the higher accelerated energies of the last few weeks, I feel, have now given way to the depth of us clearing a deeper aspect of ourselves and becoming more acquainted with aspects of ourselves that maybe we have stuffed down, suppressed, or are kept avoided, really avoided. Yeah. So these energies may feel a bit heavy and may feel like you're bogged down at the moment, and I think that's why this card, the Rainbow, came through, to sort of remind us that in amongst what we're moving through, what we're going through right now, is also an upliftment, is also a powerful movement forward once we've sort of navigated these pieces of ourselves that are calling to be anchored in home and to be accepted and to be loved within and to be made whole again. So these pieces are just really, you could call it the inner child. You could call it, some of us may be working with narcissistic wounding, or deep trauma. And this is often, this is often carried in the template of the energy field from other lives, of course, but it's quite dense and quite heavy at the moment, for a few of us, as we release some of this old wounding so that we can step into more self-empowerment. Yeah, self-empowerment. So the Rainbow, yeah, and the Rainbow, and I think it's, and the second card I picked was immerse yourself in training, learning new hobbies and passions. So I feel like this is also about new, don't be too focused on the negative mind. Move yourself out of your negative patterns that are coming up. Yes, don't avoid them, but also don't luxuriate in them. You know, there's a time right now where all the light is forcing to the surface our habitual negative patterns of thinking, of emotional response, and it's easy to flow with that and go into that and sort of live it. Yeah. So we've been asked to break the cycle, break the cycle, break the cycle, and that is by choosing to do something different. You know, whether it's a hobby, whether it's your practice, whether it's connection, tribe, new reaching out, expanding your network, and also expanding yourself out of the old contraction, because we've been invited into some of the old contractions now so that we can see them more clearly. So don't judge yourself. Don't be hard on yourself if you are reverting to some old patterning, to some old responses. This is just once again here for you to sort of get more well acquainted with the pieces of yourself that no longer serve. And these pieces are coming back again because we're doing a lot of deep ancestral clearing right now, deep ancestral trauma work from the lineage. And that is inviting these patterns to the surface so that we can be more resolute in letting them go. And we have choice here. We have choice to carry on, carry on, carry on, or invite in new energy, invite new inspiration, invite new life into some of these old patterns. And that's what is coming, the Rainbow, you know, the Rainbow, the new beginning, the new way forward. It is coming. We're just in the preparation, if you will, the preparation of the releasing. You know, this is also always kind of a heavy duty time around the 8-8 portal, that prior to that, we're in the funk. Yeah, we're in the funk, we're in the purge out, if you will, so that we can move into another exalted energetic state as we move forward, as we notch up in the ascension process, as we keep lifting up our frequencies. So yes, we're in a little bit of a an interesting space right now. Yeah. And finally, before I do some channeling with light language, let it rain, allowing what is, inevitability and trust, you know? Yeah? Inevitability, trust, allowing, let it rain. So this is around, you know, allowing yourself to feel your emotional experience, not to push it away, not to push it to the side, to push it down, but to allow these maybe difficult, maybe angry, maybe sad, maybe deep emotions that has been held within your core to have some space to unravel, to have some space to release, and some space to integrate, because it's inevitable, isn't it, that they're here and they'll pop up either now or again in the future. So is it time now to have some compassion and some inner reflection and some space to allow some of these deep feelings to come out of your system so that you can light up a little more, and continue out your path and continue being of service for yourself and others, you know? So, yeah, powerful, powerful times right now, really is. So, I really wanted to hop on to sort of share a little bit of hang in there kind of energy. Don't give up, and don't feel disheartened if you are going through a big shift right now, because that is the vibe of the collective, I feel. Yeah, and the inevitability of certain aspects of the collective field and the systems that have been in place eroding. Yeah, so that is also bringing up a grief and a potential anger within the collective field right now as things change, because of course, we all want change and we all are looking for a brighter future, but then we're also very attached to who we are, how the world is, and what we want. Yeah? So when we don't get that, there's a little bit of argy-bargy potentially. So, yeah. So then notice that within yourself and notice that within others, and to allow yourself to have a little bit of compassion. Yeah? And also, I picked up these beautiful cards from a Sunny Coast resident yesterday. Her name, Elise Goodridge. Her website, High Priestess Productions. Beautiful cards. Beautiful Australian native bird cards. You can check her website out, highpriestessproductions.com. Yeah. And I just picked one card for today, and it was the Black Swan. Beautiful. She does beautiful art. It's her artwork, it's her words. Well worth a look, yeah. And she talks of the Black Swan, compassion and self-compassion, Kuan Yin, the compassionate quality. Violence or peace originates inside self. It is the thoughts you choose in each and every moment. Heaven or hell exist here on earth. Judgment is violence of the mind. It stems from fear and creates violence outside of you. Compassion is the beginning of peace. Beautiful. Just beautiful, yeah? Beautiful words, beautiful card. So this, I feel, it is, something for myself. I can own up to that. I can be truthful around that if I feel like I've got a harsh inner critic, and if I feel like I'm not doing well or not somehow not doing a good job, I get very judgmental and almost self-violent, yeah, and then angry, yeah. So it's a practice right now as we are moving through some dark density, if you will, to have some compassion for ourselves so that we don't get too critical of our progress or too critical of the way we feel if we're not feeling as on top of things, or whatever. Things go in, so everything goes in cycles, where we're typically doing a lot of deep work. This is what it is like in this time of the year, and it's just the way it is. So not to be too judgmental or scathing of yourself, and conversely of others who are also going through probably their own process at the moment and finding their own ground, new ground really in this new time, in this shift over of the nodal axis, yeah, this week of the nodes, Libra and Aries, I think it was. So again, big energies of change and rebalancing, yeah. So we're in this kind of, we've just shifted out a little of the norm, and we're kind of, ooh, where are we right now? Where are we? It's like there's a full pillar, a realignment going on. Yeah, I did a post earlier in the week with Tiger's Iron, a large pillar. Go back to that if you wish to work with your pillar, to realign your pillar. Very important right now, because we are finding new alignment. This is a new alignment piece that's coming in. So no wonder where, yes, we're on this kind of precipice of flowing into a new stream of consciousness, stream of energy, and we're just sort of fluffing off, sloughing off these pieces of ourselves that need to go now, because if we are to continue to expand and accelerate into the higher consciousness, then these pieces are needing to be loved back into integration, if you will, and a new alignment. So some of the energies that are releasing are within the blueprint, within the ancestral lines of our families that have been carried through and are no longer necessary in this new energy. So it's kind of quite a powerful, a powerful purge out. Yeah. So I will work with a few crystals. So I think Julia just posted private. Julia just posted privately. I posted these this morning. Beautiful kyanite palm stones. I just want to work with kyanite as a clearing crystal, as a clearing crystal of the third eye, of inner sight. So often, when we are in the middle of a purging, a releasing of old energies, a transition, then it's hard to see clearly, and we are often focused on the lens of the past, the lens of trauma, the lens of judgment. So we're just releasing any energies that are kind of clouding our view right now of the divine being that we are, of the perfection that we are, regardless of what has happened to us in the past, or regardless of what is held in our lineage, really. Coming back to the truth, the stone of truth, coming back to the truth, okay? So just let this energy work in your energy field, potentially your third eye, clearing, releasing, and purifying your sight. Yeah. So just taking a breath. Hey guys, and just let me grab this crystal that's wanting to come and play today, yeah? So this little beauty, I haven't even unwrapped, so I'm just going to do that with you. It's like Christmas, yeah? So this one is a pink opal, it's called. It's an engraved skull, yeah? Yeah. Wow. So this one, yeah? It's kind of got pink, it's got some white, it's really kind of beautiful, yeah. I think I'm gonna call her Pink Lady, yeah? Like the pink ladies in Greece, yeah. So, they were feisty, yeah. They had a bit of spunk, full of heart, yeah. So this is a transmission for the heart, yeah. A transmission for the heart. And if she calls you, you can message me privately. This is working with this is with working with I feel the Mother Mary energy, the Mother Mary energy. And this is for the heart, yeah. And this is just a really sweet transmission for the heart to sort of say, it's okay. Whatever you're going through today, whatever you've been going through in the past week, it will move through as everything does. Everything passes. So if you can, don't hold on. Don't hold on to what is moving through you. Don't hold on to the energies that are coming up for clearing. Try and allow them to move through with a little grace and ease. So she is coming to us with a reminder, it is safe and it is okay to let go of some of these old traumas, old self-identities that are really keeping us boxed and caged in to a place within us that is not useful. Yeah. So sometimes these cages get a little bit rattly, yeah. Sometimes these cages get a little bit rattly as we push on the edges of our boundaries, and as we move into an expanded state, the old cage feels tight and constricting. And that is what is some of us are feeling at the moment when we are feeling the frustration or anger or a bit of self-deprecation or something. It is all like trying to break out of your own cage, yeah? So again, knowing that that is a part of the growth process. You know, the smashing of the cage so that you can move through into an expanded field. Yeah. So let me just work with your heart space now around having a little bit of compassion for yourself during this releasing, yeah. So to have compassion, self-compassion, the love of the mother, the love of the feminine, to rest and feel supported and held in the field of Gaia, the great mother, to feel held and supported, even if there's aspects of your being coming up that are ready to release so that you can be more anchored in belonging, sense of self, grounded, and feeling heartful in the world. So if that's you right now, just allowing yourself to receive this love. And if you're feeling fantastic and blissful and all good things right now, allow this to be just a transmission for your heart, yeah? And transition of divinity. So yeah, so pink opal, yeah, pink opal skull, beautiful. So take a breath, guys. Yeah. And I'm just going to finish off with a piece for the base chakra, the base grounding, holding, and just really providing that beautiful net or grounded container for us to hold. What the pillar really to hold the pillar of light that we are, as this pillar kind of gets finds redirection, finds rebalancing, finds a new beginning cosmically with what you're connecting to. Yeah. So this is like you're like when we're going through this nodal axis shift in a planetary sense, it's also working up through the astral chakras also is what I hear. And so then. Do, 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 do. Yeah, and so when you're doing the chakra pillar work, you also have to remember that also from your crown up is also going through realignment. So this is why sometimes you can feel a little voidal, yeah, or a little like, where's my support team, or where the energies that support me are accessing, blah, 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 blah. And that is sometimes because they move back and you go through a little bit of a, you go through a little bit of a realignment with your source point connections. Yeah. Source point connections. So if this is what is happening right now, I feel as well as this realignment within, those that are very spiritually connected may be feeling a little lost. Maybe feeling a little unknown, some inner child stuff could be coming up, abandonment, blah blah blah, who am I, where am I, blah blah blah. So this is natural part of a realignment piece so that we can move into a new phase. So if any of that stuff is coming up for you, just to remember not to crucify yourself for that. And just remember that you are in the right place. You are in the place you need to be right now for your being to experience a shift in alignment and bring in new access, galactic tonal access points to your being so that you can carry on your service work or your alignment process of your ascension in a deeper, more profound way. So this is a deepening process, you know, a deepening process of your soul at this time, of the collective soul, really. Yeah. So, yeah, so I just want to introduce another gorgeous skull. This came in this week as well. I don't think I have shared this one before. This guy is hematite with pyrite. He's very special, yeah, very special guy. And he is very heavy, very grounding. I love the pyrite aspect, the gold ray abundance. So this one is he's just here to really provide our base some firm foundation, yeah, some firm foundation from which to realign the rest of the pillar, yeah, all the way up, yeah. So just allow this energy to just allow this energy to anchor through you in whatever way feels supportive, if it feels right for you at this time. In your basal area. So that could be anywhere from the Earth Star soles of your feet all the way through your legs and into your perineum floor and the base chakra area. So we're just working with your anchor. Yeah? We're just working with your anchor to stabilize you while you're going through this this pillar shift, if you will. Yeah? Oshkondo io durak io undur ke bono. Shombodo de urkondoro o. Oshkondoro io undur ke beduko oro o. Unde inge undo ungo o yandaraga. In de e undur ke a. Andar ke undo e ishke bedeki. I. Ishke barndar ke anna na. Shilebediki urko undur ke anna arka anna. Shandariki, Shilebarana, Shileberana, Shandarikiana, Ushkundo, Ianda, Andarkishkipata, Erski, Alakar, Eishkil, Urko, Uno, Ushuno, Ushkuno, Oyana, Ushkuno, Oyana, Ushkuno, Oyana, Kanaka, Ushkuniuno, Urko, Uno. So he actually holds the energy of the silver dragons. The silver dragons, ancient beings, yeah. Kushkondore Iana, offering us empowerment. Gushkudurgiana, offering us the goal to the kingdom, abundance spiritually, and building in a new foundation in our lower body to support the upper chakra system as we develop new galactic support alignments. Yeah, so it's like we are needing to go deeper into the earth and up above too. So like as the conduit, yes, as the conduit, we are, we're being invited to stretch both to the heavens and to the earth more deeply. Yeah, as always, you know, if we're going to reach higher and clearer in our axitonal resonance through our astral chakras, then we really do need to go deeper into the earth too, so that we can hold ourselves, yeah, so that we can hold our light, and so that we can really come from a grounded foundational place that is anchored in the earth, supporting the expansion of the earth's consciousness, as well as bringing the frequencies of our soul alignment from above. So do any other questions while I'm here? And I will introduce yet another piece because he's here and he's just kind of noisy right now. So these three skulls, pretty special skulls today, and all very different, all very powerful in their own right. Yeah. This guy. Thank you, Murray. Thank you so much. This guy, he's cute, isn't he? So this guy is a white jade. White jade skull, galactic skull. Yeah. Lab eyes, labradorite eyes, yeah. So, you know, because there's so much energy releasing, so much ancestral, so much family clearing going on through our own DNA at the moment, yeah. I'm just gonna work with this. I posted him yesterday. Has a Lyran frequency, you know. So Lyra is the 12th dimensional aspect of Dorishiriki, feline energy, also very prominent at this time as we approach the Lion's Gate. 8-8. So, a purity, yeah, a purity in the energy could also be paralleled to the Buddhist deity White Tara. So again, feminine presence as well, a feminine, even though he's a male, a masculine skull, I feel like he has quite a strong feminine frequency too. And this White Tara is really just a purification. Now, a purification of the core, the central core, because so much is been spun out at the moment within this new alignment with the nodal axis shift. Yeah, so much has been, especially I feel from the heart solar plexus area. Yeah, from the heart and the solar plexus area. So this is like a white beam, yeah. So much like a white beam of energy that is coming into your central channel to really to create, yes, thanks, Marie, to create some softening in the heart space, some warmth in the heart space, to relax out of reflexive conditioning and defense mechanisms when we're feeling vulnerable, if you will, and to move into freedom beyond what we believe ourselves and our conditioning, we are ego, if you will. Yeah. But having said all that, really, just to really to really just listen to this energy of White Tara, of Lyra, to bring through this purity of essence, 12-dimensional being frequency, feline frequency, intuition, just to bring in a softening into your central core, so that you feel that you can just shift a little in your frequency, in your pillar, in your alignment, with ease, grace, and without too much trouble. Yeah? So just taking a breath. So some of you may be getting called to mix up your practice right now. I feel like because of the level of releasing that's going on, you may be wanting to shift your diet a little. Or your supplements that you take. That isn't something that is compulsory, but I feel that some of us are needing to just a little extra support during the purification process this month. Obviously, and always using water for purification, whether it's whether it's bathing, swimming, and even infrared saunas are really powerful to sort of really cleanse the blood and get a good sweat on to detox. Yeah, so any of that kind of stuff to help your body system to release, I think, is always useful at this time. I do have the Parisian Beach workshop on next weekend. Yeah, that one is Reclaim Your Egyptian Magic, a precursor to the 88 portal. If you wish to tune in live or face to face, you may do. I'll post the link below. I'll be back in Sydney for the 88 Lionsgate. I'll be doing some private sessions, one-on-ones, around the 8th of August in Sydney. And also, if you wish to connect with any of the skulls today, please shout out. I will be holding on to this little hematite pyrite beauty till I feel around the 8-8. But if you want to connect with him, you can send me a message. The other two are available now if you wish to connect with them. Sending you love, sending you blessings. I hope that you have a beautiful day or evening if you're overseas. It's a powerful time of transformation, so be easy on yourself and others. A lot coming up. Shout out if you wish to connect for a one-to-one online in the next week. Otherwise, I hope to see you in the event next Sunday afternoon here on the Sunshine Coast. Take care, beautiful peeps. Nice to connect with you this Sunday. Hope you're going well. Take care. Bye-bye. Bye for now.